For longtime book fans, there is no doubt that Redwall coming to Netflix is a big deal.
We'll finally get to see this medieval animal fantasy fiction on screen, watching warrior mice, squirrels, otters, badgers, and rabbits fight rats, foxes, and wildcats to protect the weak and ensure peace and justice in their lands.
The last and only film adaptation of some of Redwall's adventures was the 1999 to 2002 Canadian animated TV series, which was quite good. But come on, it took place almost two decades ago, and its three seasons weren't even nearly enough to give credit to such an awesome book series. But what's so special about Netflix acquiring the rights to Brian Jacques' books?
Well, for starters, Netflix bought the rights to all 22 books in the Redwall series. It's the first time a single TV company has bought the rights to an entire series at once. Netflix definitely means business and sees great potential in this franchise, since it intends to do both a feature film and an animated series based on the Redwall stories.
The feature film will be based on the first book in the series, called Redwall, and the animated show will be based on events from Martin the Warrior's adventures. But maybe the best news about the Redwall feature film is that its script will be written by Patrick McHale, the creator of the Over the Garden Wall animated miniseries. Anyone who's seen Over the Garden Wall knows that involving Patrick McHale in the Redwall project means a result of exceptional quality. Patrick McHale won't shy away from the dark moments of the book, and will be able to capture the atmosphere of the novel for both kids and adults to enjoy. Also, there is a chance that McHale will choose the traditional animation for the Redwall feature movie. And remembering how well it worked in Over the Garden Wall, and how well Atla and LOK, both remarkable 2D animated series, worked for Netflix's audience, it would be a real treat.
In fact, that's another reason why Redwall coming to Netflix means a lot. Redwall has been an introduction of fantasy fiction for kids for several decades already. In fact, it's the best children's fantasy fiction of its kind. It has talking animals, plenty of adventures, and also a sense of realism that always raises stakes for fantasy and books in general. In Brian Jacques' stories, bad things happen, and good guys and gals die from time to time. Still, justice, friendship, and love prevail after all.
So, in a nutshell, Redwall will hopefully not only be considered worthy by nostalgic fans, kids will adore it as well. And, according to Alan Ingram, representative of the Redwall Abbey Company, which owned the rights to Brian Jacques' books after his death, Brian would have been very happy to see that Netflix shares his joy and desire to bring his stories to life as a new universe of films, series, and potentially much more for audiences of all ages to enjoy.
And what do you guys think? Are you excited about Redwall coming to Netflix? Which book of the series would you rather see on screen?
Let us know in the comments!
And don't forget to subscribe to Cartoon Junkies!